My name is Phil Meyer and I would like to present you my talk with the title Feature Extraction with Half-Seed Region Drawing as Data Compression for Distributed Computing. Let me first give you a bit of an outline of the talk. I start with a bit of a motivation before I describe our sensing setup. After that, I'm going to talk a bit about the used algorithms before I show some experimental results and end with a conclusion. So, as you all probably know, the number of electronic devices in modern cars is steadily increasing. At the moment, there are often several different bus systems in use that are application dependable, like safety critic, infotainment, comfort applications, and so on. With the upcoming autonomous driving features, there is even more data that has to be transmitted around the whole car, especially from several different sensors. The data has to be transmitted to do a sensor fusion somewhere. This is often done in a distributed computing environment where the bandwidth could be problematic for state-of-the-art bus systems. To experiment in such applications, we've built ourselves a mobile robot platform which is equipped with mechanical wheels for maximized maneuverability. We designed this platform for experiments in our indoor environment, and this platform can be equipped with several different sensor systems like radar, ultrasonic, or the depth imaging sensors used in this work. The communication here is done via Ethernet. As a sensor itself, we use the ASUS Ixion sensors, which are structured light sensors. They consist of an IR source and an IR camera, which are used for the range imaging. Additionally, they have an RGB camera and a stereo microphone within, but that are not used for this work. The interesting part of the sensors are that they generate a 3D point cloud, which is a data structure that is similar to big LiDAR sensors, but for a much lower price tag. The whole setup looks like follows. We have a set of our LiDAR sensors here, one for each direction. The data from the sensors is then pre-processed in a Raspberry Pi where we run our algorithms, and the extracted features on the Raspberry Pi then are sent to an Intel NUC where the data fusion could be done. So, to give you a brief overview, first of all, since we designed this platform for an indoor use, our method is applicable to find planar surfaces like walls, floors, and so on. First, we use the Huff transformation to find a mathematical description for a found plane. Then we have to use this data, is then put in an Graham scan algorithm, which generates an convex hull around the found points for this plane. At this point, we have to find out which points belong to this plane that we found. Therefore, we do a point in polygon test with a ray casting. And finally, we have the region growing method that is our main method that generates us a complete description. This process is then iterated here in a loop here, as long as there are points that are not associated with a found plane. So, to give you a brief overview over the used algorithm, first the Huff transformation. The Huff transformation was developed by Paul Huff in the 1960s to find traces in the bubble chamber, which is a device in nuclear physics. The idea of this method is to transform a binary picture into the so-called Huff space, which is a parameter space. So this parameter space is application dependent. For our approach, we use a so-called randomized variant, where we not use the whole data sets on only random selected points. This is done for computational effort. Since we want to find planes in our data set, we have to find a mathematical description for planes. We choose the Hessian normal form, which consists of a normal vector n0 and the distance of the found plane to the center of the coordinate system. The Huff transformation then generates a list of points that are associated with this plane, but the list is not complete. Therefore, we only know the orientation of the plane and not and the distance from our sensor, but not the size. This is unsuitable for navigational purposes. Then we have the region growing algorithm, which is an iterative algorithm that adds one point to a found player that adds one point to a list of points that describe one plane. The idea of this algorithm is based on the principal component analysis, so the data points are interpreted as a 3D distributed variable. This distributed variable can be described with its covariance matrix, and the eigenvectors and the eigenvalues of this matrix can describe the plane. Since one point is added at each after each iteration, the principal components analysis must be performed after each step. This is surely problematic because it makes the whole algorithm quite slow. As you can see here, the basic idea we have here, I tried to draw a bit. This sphere, all points that belong to a specific plane are properly lie in the sphere. And then if we interpret it as a covariance, which is covariance matrix, the largest eigenvalue, the eigenvectors to the both largest eigenvalue, in this example V1 and V3, span the plane, and the eigenvector to the smallest eigenvalue is perpendicular to this plane and is equivalent with a normal vector to this plane. So, additionally, furthermore, we had to use some helping algorithms. At first, we have to use Graham scan. This method was introduced in the 1970s. It uses a finite list of points and finds a convex hull around these points in a 2D space. This is done by iterating through this list and examine if the point, the actual point, in this case, this one, is left or right from a line that runs from the former point to the next point. So if it's on the left, on the right side of this line, it certainly belongs to the convex hull of the polygon, or if it's on the right side, it belongs to the convex hull. If it's on the left side, it doesn't belong to the hull and is deleted from the list of edge points. So furthermore, we had to find out which points belong to a polygon that is described from the Graham scan. Therefore, we used a ray casting algorithm, which is a standard method from computer graphics. It needs a list of the vertices of the polygon and the points that we want to test, and then it sends out a virtual ray to a desired site and counts the intersection with a convex hull of the polygon. If the number of intersection is odd, like for this one, the point lies in the polygon. If the number of intersection is even, for example this or this one, the point is out of the polygon. So with this workflow, we conducted some experiments. First, you can see here, this is our reference scene in our lab. We have here the sensor, the action sensor, and here a plane that was opposed to it in a desired distance. And here you see the results of our process. As you can see, we found a good description for the floor plane, and we found the wall with a bit of artifacts from the heater piping, and certainly we found the opposing plane. Then you can see here are some points that were associated to one plane or another. This is caused because for this example, we choose the parameters that steer the whole process too narrow, and the algorithm were not able to differentiate if these points belong to this plane or this plane. So, furthermore, then if we go outside our lab, we find a hallway, as you can see here. Here you can see the raw data. There is no opposing wall that the sensor can see, but you have the walls to the left and to the right, and also a bit of a floor that the sensor also acknowledges and finds. this is not a complete description for the whole way, but it should be sufficient for navigational purposes, because it is on the one hand this is done with a one shot measurement, so there's no continuous, for this example there was no continuous measurement. And on the other hand, there was no continuous measurement, but still we can see, okay, here are obstacles and here is free space where we can drive. Then we got another experiment. If we go down the hall, we arrive at a staircase. Here we place the sensor on front of the first step. And as you can see, here is the raw data and here are the generated polygons with our algorithm. So the method finds the large polygons, the opposing plane, and even here, and even on the right side, it can differentiate between the handrail and the wall. So here we match the parameter of the controlling parameters quite well. So in conclusion, we combine two algorithms, combination of the random half transformation with the region growing algorithm leads to an acceleration of the later method of around 50%. This was simply done because we increased the number of seed points and therefore decreased the number of necessary and computed of the necessary iterations, which reduced the computing effort significantly. Furthermore, we found that since we described the found planes by the edge points of the polygon that we found, we can reduce the data needs to be transmitted to 1% of a full frame for each sensor. This is done because we reduce the redundancy and replaces with prior knowledge. For example, for one shot, we needed an average of 6,000 bytes that were transmitted, opposing the 600,000 bytes or 600 kilobytes that were needed with a full frame. So that was all. Thanks for your attention, and I would gladly answer any questions.